The St. Lucia Civil Service Association stayed away from the meeting with the Prime Minister and other Ministry of Finance officials last week. That meeting was summoned to discuss the state of the economy and ways of reducing government expenditure. The CSA dismissed the meeting as an exercise in futility, saying that the 5% pay cut was already a done deal, in which case there was really nothing to discuss. Now Castries Southeast MP Guy Joseph has come out on the side of the CSA and accused the government of withholding information.
The silence of the government on this whole matter, leading up to budget and legislating beforehand, before discussing with anybody, is a cause for concern. For the simplest reason, I think that information is deliberately being withheld from all persons.
According to Mr. Joseph, the opposition members only received the section of the recent estimates of expenditure dealing with salaries on the morning of the budget debate. He's asserting that it was not a part of the original document and is joining the CSA in its claims that the government is not being truthful about its intentions for the public service. He is also accusing some union leaders of conspiring with the government to undermine others.
It is sad that this is what we have come to. It is sad that some union leaders who are adamant when UWP was in office, you know that when we ask for an extra, for a little extra time to pay, we never said we were not going to pay. All we ask is to give us a few months so that these same unions went on strike today. What are they saying?
The government and unions will meet again this week in an attempt to come up with a mutually acceptable solution to the issue. The Prime Minister says the island is facing serious economic challenges, but that its public sector salaries remain among the highest in the Eastern Caribbean Currency Union. For the DBS News World, Kendall Burton reporting.